Neuropsychologists measure thinking skills. So we do that for a couple of reasons. It can tell us about how the different parts of the brain are functioning. So we have a good idea about how different thinking skills like memory relate to different parts of the brain. And so if there's something wrong with a part of the brain, we can detect that by measuring it, and then we can help a neurologist or general practitioner work out what's happening for a patient in their brain, and that can then help with treating it. The other major thing that I do is measure thinking skills so we can hopefully predict the outcome of potential surgery. In addition to measuring memory, attention, and language, we really do try to put the psychological component with it. So we really want to understand what that person's day-to-day life is like, how their thinking skills are affecting their relationships with others, with their partner, with their children. Sitting there for 5 hours with a patient and really focusing on trying to understand them is just absolutely fascinating. You get a total portal into someone's life, and it gives you a really good appreciation of what your life is like, and I think it gives you an opportunity to just really learn a lot more as a person. It's really cool.